Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to Why, a series of questions that we are asking ourselves to remind ourselves and ask ourselves sincerely and honest, why? And here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this time is asking us, in which He calls upon the believers and He says, all those who believe, why? Why is it when it comes to striving in the path of Allah, you grew up so tight into this world? Why? Why is it when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you to strive and do something that will please Him and uphold Islam, you grab so tight onto this world, you don't want to let go of this world. You don't want to let go of this dunya. And then Allah azza wa jalla says, do you accept this world over the hereafter? Do you accept to live in this world and you don't want to live in the hereafter? Do you replace the paradise with this world? Then Allah azza wa jalla says, the luxury of this world is nowhere near the luxury of the hereafter. The luxury of this world is nowhere near what Allah has prepared for you in the paradise. So why is it when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to strive and do something for His religion, we are so hesitant? We don't want to let go. We become so busy and occupied with everything else. And we don't want to do what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it comes to striving for other things, such as striving for wealth, such as striving for money, such as striving for anything else in this world, we work so hard and we strive so hard and we do our best. But when it comes to the religion of Allah, when it comes to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we become so hesitant, we become so lazy, we become so ignorant and we become so negligent. Why? Why is it Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord and our Master, is asking this question? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see us that we reply with a sincere heart. Allah Azza wa Jal wants us to be honest with ourselves. Who is more important? Is Allah more important to us? Or is this world more important to us? Is Allah and His religion are more important to us? Or is this dunya and the wealth of this dunya are more important to us? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, whoever looks forward to meet Allah, Allah looks forward to meet them. And whoever does not look forward to meet Allah, Allah does not look forward to meet them. So Aisha said, O Messenger of Allah, are you referring to death? Every single one of us hates death. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, no, I am referring to the believer. When this believer does good and this believer pleases Allah in his life, he knows what Allah had prepared for him from His pleasure and from His mercy and from the paradise. Therefore, this believer looks forward to meet Allah. And in return, Allah looks forward to meet him. But the non-believer, the disobedient person to Allah, he knows what he's done in this world. He knows the disobedience that he had disobeyed his Lord in this world. He knows the wrongs that he's done in this world. He knows what wrong and he knows what Allah had prepared for him from the punishment of the hellfire. Therefore, he does not look forward to meet Allah, nor that Allah looks forward to meet them. My brother and my sister, do you look forward to meet Allah? Are you from amongst those who are looking forward to meet Allah because of the good they've done in this dunya? Because of the good they've done to please Allah, because of their obedience, because of their salah, because of their fasting, because of their zakat, because of the good deeds they've done in the grave. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, when someone is in the grave, when this dead person is in the grave, lonely and surrounded by the darkness and the worms and the dust, while he is in that state, what appears to him? A very good looking person appears to him. So this dead person will say, by Allah, your face looks like someone with good news. So he'll say to him, yes, I am your good deeds. I am your good deeds by Allah. You were so quick to obeying Allah, very slow when it came to disobeying Him. But this disobedient servant of Allah, this non-believer who disobeyed Allah and neglected Allah in this world while he is in that grave lonely, while he's in that grave in that darkness, surrounded by the worms and the dust, a very ugly person will appear to him. And then he'll say to him, by Allah, your face looks like someone with bad news. So he'll say to him, yes, I'm your bad deeds. I am your bad deeds, by Allah. You were very quick when it came to disobeying Allah, very slow when it came to obeying Him. My brother and my sister, are you from those who are quick when it comes to obeying Allah? Are you from those who are quick when it comes to obeying Allah, slow when it comes to disobeying Him? When it's time for the salah, you get up. When it's time to obey Allah, you get up. When it's time to do good, you do. Or are you from those who are very slow to obeying Allah, very quick to disobeying Him? very slow when it comes to obeying Allah. But when it comes to seeing the haram, or saying the haram, or touching the haram, or walking to the haram, you are very, very, very quick. Let us be honest with ourselves and ask ourselves this sincere question. Who is more important to me in this life? What is the most important thing to me in this life? Who is the most important one to me in this life? Is Allah the most important one to you? Is Islam the most important thing to you? Or is this world the most important thing to you? Is the love of Allah more beloved? Is the love of Allah more important to you in your heart? Is it the most thing in your heart? Or the love of this world is the most beloved thing in your heart? Remember, the love of Allah cannot be combined with the love of this dunya. The love of the hereafter cannot be combined with the love of this dunya. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, be in this dunya like a stranger or someone who is just traveling and stopping for a short while or moment just to rest or to transit. This is the quality of the mu'min. The mu'min and the believer, the most important thing to them is Allah. The most important thing to them is Islam, because they live for Allah. Because they live for Islam, their life revolves around the obedience of Allah. Their life revolves around the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the mu'min. This is the Muslim. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls upon the believers. And he says, why? Why is it when Allah commands you to strive in his path, you become so hesitant? Why are you hesitant to please Allah? Why are you hesitant to obey Allah? Why are you hesitant to go forward to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Don't be hesitant. Don't be hesitant, my brother and my sister. Obey your Lord. Be so quick in obeying Allah. Be very slow when it comes to disobeying Him. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember that Allah azza wa jal is the most important one. And remember Islam is the most important thing in your life. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us and to make us from those who listen and hear, act upon what they listen and hear. Subhanak Allahum bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك